Hello everybody, this is Fernando for the latest Godzilla podcast. As mentioned a few days back, it looks like Godzilla team was going to be at the WonderCon Comic Con that just came about this weekend, and several news outlets have reported on what was displayed there and then who showed up, so I'm going to talk about some of that footage on there. And I think the stuff is still out there on the internet right now. I was sent several links, but some of the stuff isn't working, so I'm not sure if it's being taken down or not. But otherwise, at least with regards to text descriptions, there's some good analysis stuff that's done out there by other websites. Like, for example, MTV.com has a pretty good analysis of what happens, and I'll include a link to them directly below, so that way you can check it out. But I'll talk about some of the stuff that stood out. Sure enough, Gareth Edwards is doing his world tour, it seems, of the Godzilla movie, and he was there on hand at the WonderCon, and he was there to introduce all the attendees there to what they called an exclusive clip. And it looks like, based on the description of the clip, it was the same one that was played at the South by Southwest festival just last month. And the reason I mention it's the same one is because it opens with that subway car scene where Aaron Taylor-Johnson's character, I guess he's trying to comfort a young boy as the power goes out. And then that's when it interlopes with footage of, I guess, that Hawaiian beach, the one that shows that young girl watching something, like essentially the waters recede back, and then the footage of everybody running from there along with the dog running away on there. And looks like here, with regards to Godzilla, he comes out, but the only time that the footage shows, because the rest of the footage pretty much just shows him either as his tail or his legs, maybe his arm here and there, but the only time they showed him full on was that scene that that was shown also at the South by Southwest Con, the convention. That was when Godzilla faces off against one of the Mutos at the airport, and it pans up to him about to essentially take on the Muto. So that's the footage that was shown on there. Pretty cool stuff. This is the same stuff again that was presented at the South by Southwest Con, and if I'm not mistaken, it was at the London exhibition as well. So after that, Edwards talked about the design of the Godzilla. What was surprising to learn was that it took a year, that's right, a whole year to finalize Godzilla's design. And he said the reason for that was they looked at all angles, literally all angles, when it came to designing Godzilla. So if they designed Godzilla and he looked fine from the front, then the way they designed him is they would create him as a 360-degree model. Then they would move him to the side. And if the side shot using what was created from the front now looked weird, then they started all over. Same thing would happen is, let's say they designed him from the back and it looked really, really cool, but then they shifted him over to the front using that same back design, and if from the front angle it looked strange, then again they started all over on there. A year seems like a long time to me. I think essentially what inevitably became the final look is not really too far off. It's probably like 95% there from any other Godzilla film, so I'm wondering why they took so long, a year, to do this. Something like as far as the 1998 film, now that's a whole reimagining outside of the spikes themselves, so that would have been something that seemed like it took a while to design. But ultimately, the final design here, while it looks pretty cool, again, it's only like, what, 95% different from any of the other Godzilla designs that we've seen in the past. So Gareth also mentioned that he based this essentially on Spielberg. Like, he wanted to have that huge commercial appeal while at the same time making it a personal film. And that's what Spielberg does. He always makes these films where they reach a global audience, but at the same time they're focusing on a short amount of people within the film itself. And he also mentioned that he wanted to make sure that Godzilla wasn't just any other monster, but a character with clear motivations. And I guess the reason for this was he wanted to create, of course, Godzilla to have a, not like, I guess you could call it a personality, but something that would make him ultimately the hero of the film, even if he is a quote-unquote anti-hero. where he's doing heroic stuff, not through good intentions, but through his own actions, it is helping out in the end on there. Very, very cool stuff. And otherwise, people were, I guess, at the convention, they were coming up and asking him questions like in any other Q&A at a Comic-Con convention. And he said that everything as far as all the thanks, he said, just hold off until you've seen the movie. And then that way, once the movie comes out, then he'll definitely be appreciative of all the thanks on there, because ultimately the movie itself is the final judgment of whether he did a good job or not. So pretty cool stuff. So check out the link if you have a chance. There's some more stuff with regards to what happened at the Comic-Con on there. And again, I'll see if there's anything else with regards to other footage. But otherwise, thanks again, everybody. Take care.